ABC7 honors this year's top scholars.
Hi, everyone. I'm Alan Wong. We're here on the campus of UC Berkeley today to introduce you to the 2011 ABC7 Top Scholars. This program was established to promote academic excellence by honoring and rewarding some of the Bay Area's top high school seniors. During the next half hour, you'll meet the six students who are this year's scholarship winners. Their stories go beyond their achievement in the classroom. This year's top scholars are all leaders of exceptional character, and each one has a unique background and inspiring personal story to tell. Now stay tuned to meet the 2011 ABC7 Top Scholars. Invitations to participate in the ABC7 Top Scholar Program went out to hundreds of schools throughout the Bay Area. We're looking for the best and brightest college-bound high school seniors. We received 150 applications from more than 70 different high schools, leaving our panel of 14 judges with some difficult decisions in choosing our top scholars. Each applicant had at least a 3.7 GPA and an impressive list of school activities and honors. In the end, there was a short essay intended to introduce the applicants that set our winners apart from the rest. You'll get to hear these young adults relate their stories firsthand in their upcoming profiles. Each of our winners will receive a $1,000 scholarship that'll go to his or her college education. We begin with a young woman from Walnut Creek whose passion for eating healthy helped change the food that was being served in her high school cafeteria. Let's meet Las Lomas High School's Emlyn Erickson.
Hi, my name is Emlyn Erickson. I live in Walnut Creek. I go to Las Lomas High School, and next fall I'll be attending Duke University. I think the main thing that drives me to succeed is how much other people have invested in me. I've had a ton of support from my family, from my community. My teachers have been unreal, and I think that I owe it to them and to myself to take advantage of the opportunities I've been given and go as far as I can.
I think the travels that Emlyn has experienced in the last 3 years have done so much to shape where she's going from this point on in her life, especially her time in Nicaragua, where she worked at the clinic, the health clinic, and that seems to be the thing that really made her realize she wants to go into medicine.
It's something that I've been thinking about for a long time, and I have this personal incentive to do it, having been to Nicaragua, having lived with the people there, having worked in the medical clinic. It's something that I know I'm interested in. I know that I want to be involved in helping people in the international community.
So this is our salad bar.
So I started Club Veg this year because I really wanted to create a community for the vegetarians at my school. Our focus has really become bringing healthy choices to Las Lomas. We submitted a grant proposal and Whole Foods chose our grant and gave us a salad bar. They donated all of the equipment we need. I'm really excited about it from a health standpoint and from a more vegetarian, vegan-friendly option standpoint.
Very nice. What does the sheep say?
Bah!
I work in the crisis nursery every Saturday. I've been working there for the past 5 months, and I love working in the crisis nursery. It's so rewarding. I love working with the kids. The nursery is a place where parents can drop their kids off if they're going through a personal crisis or a family crisis. Battered women use the nursery when they need to get away from whatever abusive relationship they're in. So it's just a really great resource to have in the community.
That doesn't look fantastic, does it? That was the medical clinic. That's where I worked.
Over the next 4 years, I hope to finish a major in international comparative studies with a concentration in Latin America and the Caribbean, a minor in Chinese, a certificate program in global health, and perhaps a second minor in medical anthropology.
Congratulations to Emlyn Erickson on becoming an ABC7 Top Scholar with her 4.7 grade point average. She's headed to Duke University this fall, where she promises to remain committed to those less fortunate by pursuing a career in international medicine. Welcome back. Let's head to the South Bay for the profile of our next top scholar, Kyle Gerner, whose unique versatility stretches from acting to music to sports and caring for horses, all while giving back to his community.
Hi, I'm Kyle Gerner. I'm from Cupertino, and I go to King's Academy in Sunnyvale, and next fall I'll be going to Santa Clara University. I always, I'm looking for opportunities to learn a little bit more about something, to kind of improve myself, I guess. And I can see a lot of different ways that I'm growing.
We sometimes think of him as a Renaissance teenager, if there's ever such a thing as that, because he's so well-rounded and has so many different interests and activities. And he's very unpretentious about it all. You kind of have to discover these things slowly.
So I started playing the trumpet when I was 9 years old in fourth grade. I joined the California Youth Symphony. That was in seventh grade, and I've been playing in the senior orchestra for 3 years. Played with the California Philharmonic Youth Orchestra. I toured with them to New York and played in Carnegie Hall. I started riding horses when I was five. When I was 13, I was old enough to start in a trainee program where you get to kind of work hands-on with the horses more. You're getting horses ready for lessons, you're taking care of, you're getting people out on trail rides.
So let's go ahead and give them a little squeeze and let's head on out.
I'm involved a little bit with kind of veterinary stuff. I get given shots, I take care of medicine a little bit. I just absolutely love it. So one day in fourth grade, I went and I saw a Giants-Dodgers game up in San Francisco, and I was just hooked. Yeah, I played for about 6 years. Played for high school, my freshman and sophomore year, I did JV. I loved playing, but it just got to be too much of a commitment with all the other things that I was doing. I focused more on the music and the acting.
Hi. Isn't this a strange moss-covered rock?
So Jesters is it's a group of nine. It's an acting group. We go around to elementary schools, preschools, and we perform skits for little kids, just classic fairy tales kind of stories from children's books, stuff like that. This year I decided I'll audition for the fall play and did that. I got a pretty good role, and I just thought I had a blast. I'm like, okay, I'm definitely doing the musical now. And so I auditioned for that, and I got the lead role in the musical. We did 42nd Street this year, and I was Julian. And that was right up there, one of the three biggest highlights, I think, of my high school career was doing that. So next year, I'm Santa Clara. I'm thinking at the moment I want to be either a people doctor or a vet. Not quite sure which one it'll be yet, but I think that's where I'm headed right now.
Congratulations to Cupertino's Kyle Gerner on becoming an ABC7 Top Scholar. With his 3.9 GPA, he's headed to Santa Clara University this fall, where he'll remain committed to the performing arts and caring for horses. Our next Top Scholar took on the challenge of stand-up comedy to raise awareness about a deadly disease that hit close to home. Let's take a look at the work of Presentation High School's Sarah Casarovi.
Hi, my name is Sarah Casarovi. I'm from Saratoga. I attend Presentation High School, and next fall I will be attending the University of Southern California. I kind of get a thrill from putting in effort and from persevering and stuff, so kind of just that sense of achievement after putting in so much effort is just really fulfilling for me.
She is beyond smart, and her smart, what I love is it's a combination of book smart, street smart, and just simple joy of learning.
I am a girl from the 21st century having to struggle with immigrant parents from the 16th century.
I got started with stand-up comedy. It's sort of a long story. When I was 7 years old, my grandma passed away. And my grandma was sort of the rock to my family, the rock to my life. She was my role model. She passed away, and that was really hard for our entire family, especially my mom, who became really depressed after that. And as a 7-year-old, I was sort of lost, and I didn't know where to turn. I cracked a joke one day just through serendipity, and I saw my mom smile for the first time in a very long time. And I knew that I had to get that reaction more. My grandma passed away of a disease called scleroderma. It's an autoimmune disease that affects a large percentage of women. And there's not a lot of awareness out there. And so I always made it a mission to me to remember my roots, sort of, in terms of comedy. And whenever I would perform for places and all the earnings that I would get, I would make it a point to always donate those to the Scleroderma Research Foundation, which I have been doing since age 11. So I think to date, probably around $17,000 I've been able to donate to that foundation.
Well, since we don't have time to hold auditions, I thought I'd simply cast the play randomly.
So I constantly remind myself, I'm doing this, you know, to entertain other people. The whole reason why I started this was to make people smile, was for that feeling of like, I just made that person happier. I just made that person, you know, forget their worries for 5 seconds and live in a world of like laughter. And so when I remember the reason behind why I'm doing this and to lift, it is to lift people's spirits, it kind of, I guess, centers me and makes me realize, okay, you can do this. You're doing this to make them laugh. So go out there, be calm, and do it for your audience.
Excuse me, Mrs. Sunny Sack. The back of my script says assistant director.
I've often said to Sarah, I'm almost afraid to be inside your mind because your mind is just going in so many directions at the same time, and yet somehow you keep it all together. And she truly does.
I have met unbelievable people in my class, in my grade, who have done such phenomenal things, and I almost feel like that inspires me to be the best that I can be, is knowing people my age who have such a thirst for life.
Congratulations to Saratoga's Sarah Kasrovi on becoming an ABC7 Top Scholar. With her 4.5 GPA, Sarah's headed to USC this fall, and she aspires to take on the LA Comedy Club circuit while continuing to raise funds for scleroderma research. Welcome back. As we continue our profiles of the 2011 ABC7 Top Scholars, we head to San Mateo for a look at Aragon High School's Amrit Saxena, whose passion for leadership and math has earned him the respect of everyone around him.
Hi, I am Amrit Saxena. I live in Foster City. I'm currently attending Aragon High School, and I will be attending Stanford University in the fall. My biggest passion in life is to share knowledge, is to take what I know and what I learn and give it back to my community.
He's extremely bright. He just understands things without any difficulty. And he's just a human sponge as far as information. He's interested in almost everything.
The answer to number 33 is y equals sine x plus 3. So basically, I've always been very interested in math, and I took calculus as a sophomore, which was the highest math course offered at Aragon at the time. The math department chair asked me if I would be interested in teaching a math class as a senior because I would have run out of math classes to take at Aragon by then. And then at the end of junior year, he asked me if I would like to teach one of his classes for him. And it was a very exciting prospect because I would be able to directly apply what I've learned and teach a number of students every day for a whole year. And I immediately said yes, and I have been teaching one of his classes this entire year. I also sub for other math classes at Aragon. I've taught Algebra 3-4, AP Statistics. I've even delved into multivariable calculus at times. Student government has always been a very important aspect of my life. I feel like it is very important for students to go out and get involved in their communities, and student government sets up a perfect opportunity for students to do so. I've served as class president of my high school for 4 consecutive years. Throughout those years, I have organized around 40 fundraisers, events, and dances, and I have raised the most financially successful class in Aragon history. Student Council provides a very tangible way for me to get involved in my community and make an immediate and legitimate difference in my scholastic and local communities.
Amrit works so hard. I would be about to go to bed at 10 o'clock at night. I would send him something and say, you know, we really should create a spreadsheet that does such and such. And the next morning it would be there and I would see that it had been sent to me at 2 o'clock in the morning. So he's tireless and thorough.
I hope to conduct academic research, which draws heavily on mathematics. I hope to get involved in governmental or economic policy, which is very mathematically intensive, or at least has the potential to be made very mathematically intensive. The opportunities are endless, and I see a lot of potential to use my passions and my talents to help better our world.
Congratulations to Foster City's Amrit Saxena on becoming an ABC7 Top Scholar. With his 4.4 GPA, he's headed to Stanford University this fall, where he'll remain committed to leading others through his continued passion for teaching math.
How are you doing?
Let's go to South San Francisco for our next profile. El Camino High's Catherine Tedina is a remarkable young woman whose interest in journalism and physics helped shape who she is.
Hi, my name is Catherine Tedina. I'm from Daly City. I go to El Camino High School, and this fall, I will be going to Stanford University. 5 years ago, we migrated to the United States from the Philippines, and seeing my parents work so hard, it just inspires me to study really hard just so that their efforts and the fact that we moved here to America and they gave up what they had in the Philippines, it just made me realize that I should work hard and give back to them. So while you guys are doing that, I'm gonna go do the same thing on the feature pages for the website. Journalism has probably been the after-school activity that I've devoted most of my time to. Actually, when I was in grade school, I was also the editor-in-chief of my elementary school's school newspaper. Moving here to the United States from the Philippines, I wanted to continue that tradition, so I decided to join the Colt Quarterly school newspaper at El Camino. What I love doing the most at journalism is the layouts, because I'm sort of a graphic design person. When I was young, I used to do a lot of HTML and CSS layouts, so I really like the graphic design aspect or the layout aspect. I also enjoyed writing for the school newspaper. I am a very curious person, and I like investigating things, looking things up. I also like physics because I like solving problems, mathematical problems. I worked as an intern at Stanford University as part of the Summer Institutes of Medical Research, SIMR program. I had no prior experience when it comes to immunology or lab research. I had to step in and do something that I've never done before.
She was doing research on lupus, and the way she came back and explained it was just unbelievable. She had done graduate level research. She had bypassed, you know, the level of undergraduate research that some undergraduates do.
I could see myself working at a research laboratory or working at an industry or probably starting up my own company, fulfilling the needs of the computer industry or something. When I was in the Philippines, I got to see the poverty that was prevalent in that country. I have this dream that maybe if I become successful here and make a change, then maybe I can give back a little to my country and help solve the poverty problem that's going on in there right now.
Congratulations to Daly City's Catherine Tedina on becoming an ABC7 Top Scholar. With her 4.5 GPA, Catherine is headed to Stanford University, where she hopes to continue her career path toward both writing and scientific research. As we conclude our profiles of the 2011 ABC7 Top Scholars, we head to Piedmont High School, where Christina Yu combined her love of Chinese martial arts and modern dance to widen her horizons.
Hi, I'm Christina Yu. I'm from Piedmont. I attend Piedmont High School, and this fall I will be attending UC Berkeley. Ever since I can remember, my parents have always taught me to always try my best in everything that I do. And with everything, with every task, with every challenge I take on, I always put in 100% effort because I know that my parents have given so much of like their lives and their efforts to give me the opportunities I have today.
She's always had the will and determination that when she sets forward to do something, she gives it her all.
My father passed away when I was very young, and that really took a toll on me and a toll on our family. And even though it was a really devastating experience to go through, it definitely has brought our family much closer. And we are the closest family like I know. We are so tight. We are each other's biggest supporters, and we're there for each other 100%. I've been practicing wushu since I was 9 years old, and I'm now a fourth degree black belt in wushu. So wushu is the contemporary style of Chinese martial arts. It's a combination of kicks, flips, twists, poses, jumps, and weapons. I love wushu because what other sport can you combine twists, kicks, and flips with weapons? Last December, I represented the US at the World Wushu Championships in Singapore, and I placed 6th in straight sword and 7th in spear, earning certificates in both. I started dancing when I was a freshman, and I had no clue that I could dance. I just went into the dance program my freshman year just because I wanted to go out of my comfort zone and I wanted to explore something new. I am planning on attending UC Berkeley this fall, and I will be studying integrative biology. But I know that integrative biology at UC Berkeley can help me become anything that I want to be to help people, which is a pharmacist, optometrist, pediatrician, or physical therapist. The doctors who helped my dad, they really inspired me to become some sort of doctor to help other people and to better their lives.
Congratulations to Christina Yu on becoming an ABC7 Top Scholar. With her 4.1 GPA, she's headed to UC Berkeley this fall, where she'll continue to participate in wushu and dance while pursuing studies in integrative biology. We hope you've enjoyed some of the best that Bay Area high schools have to offer. It's been our honor to present these stories of these inspiring young people. So congratulations to all of our top scholars and the fine schools they've attended and the ones they'll be attending later this fall. All of us here at ABC7 salute you. Now go out and make the world a better place. From the campus of UC Berkeley, I'm Alan Wong. We'll see you next year.